Let me take you to our final category, ladies and gentlemen, this evening. I'd like to call on Mukesh Dhirubhai Ambani, Chairman and Managing Director of Reliance Industries Limited, to honor the real heroes in the category of social welfare. Can we have you on stage? Ladies and gentlemen, let's look at the real heroes in this category.
The real heroes for the category social welfare are D. Raja, a home for the homeless. That's Auto Raja's mission. This Bengaluru auto driver was once a petty criminal. Today, he is a messiah for the destitute.
Even mother Teresa, she also died. Then who will care this? Then can I do this?
Auto Raja's home of hope offers dignity and life to those the world rejected. Heer Bhai Ben Ibrahim Bhai Lobi. The Siddhi community, backward, poor and forgotten. Delheer Bhai Lobi changed all that. With a loan for an organic farm, she turned the Siddhi women into entrepreneurs. She then set up a school.
मेरे बच्चों है इंग्लिश सीखेगा ऐसा हमारा सपना है.
But Heer Bhai wants more, a high school, a college, so the Siddhis can rewrite their destiny. Dr. Chandrasekhar Sankaratri. The Kanishk plane tragedy. Dr. Chandra lost his wife, lost two children, lost his whim to live. He came back to India, to his wife's Andhra village, and set up the Sarada school and the Sri Kiran Eye Hospital. In healing the poor, Dr. Chandra found a reason to live.
My loss is always there. I'm trying to do something more meaningful and more useful for others.
Sister Mariola. She opens up a world for women behind bars, helping the under trial women of Ajmer jail. With free legal aid and small ways to make their lives better. A true friend, philosopher and guide to these forgotten women. Sujata Bhatt and Kalpana Malya. In old age, when the mind is faltering and loved ones turn away, Asha Jeevan offers a safe haven, created by two women, Sujata and Kalpana, to care for the disabled and the bedridden, bringing meaning to their twilight years.
Ladies and gentlemen, our first real hero in this category of social welfare, can we have T. Raja on stage, please? We like to call him Auto Raja. Please come on stage. And he's actually come a long way, and ironically, you must have heard, he found his true calling, that's caring for the destitute, living on the streets while he was behind bars.
Thank you for this opportunity to share my work before you. I'm not a much educated person. I studied only third standard. Because of my bad friends, I lost my education. I gave a lot of trouble to my parents. My parents used to curse me, if you die, it's good for our family. They chased me out from my home. I became a destitute in the street. Sachin sir has told about Mother Teresa, impressed. And behind, same for me is the one hero is there, Christ. I ask him, make me like Mother Teresa. I want to be a good person for the society. And now God has made me a small Mother Teresa in Karnataka. I rescued more than 3,000 people past 14 years from the street. 1,400 people died in peace, in dignity, in my home. Before dying, some people, they want to drink a Pepsi, Coca-Cola, ice cream, Apple, will fulfill the last wishes and they die in peace. We are living in same campus with my wife and my three kids, and we decided to die in same place. We sacrificed my whole life for the destitute.
I want to ask you this. In those days when you were behind bars,
yeah,
as a young man on the street, did you ever think that you could change your life to the day where you'd be here today?
I never think. I know fight with the people. I know to make a problem for the public, like rowdyism, gundagiri in my area. But I never think God will change my life. I can say this is a gift from my God. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next real hero in this category is Hirbhai Ben, Ibrahim Bhai Lobi. Can we have her on stage, please? She's a true grassroots entrepreneur. She took up a loan to start an organic compost farm in order to empower women from the Siddhi community. She also set up a kindergarten school and is now aiming for a high school and college for children of the area.
मैं तो एक जंगल में रहने वाली है, यहाँ चीन चावल दीपड़ा सिया सब रहते हैं, तो मैं दूसरा लकड़ी लेके बहन आती है, इसके बारे में पढ़ाई की कोई को खबर नहीं है कि मेरे बच्चू पढ़े के ना पढ़े, इसके बाद में कुछ को खबर नहीं है। वैसे मैं एक आगे खान जैसी सस्ता आई तो मैं यहाँ एक छोटा छोटा ग्रुप बनाया। मेरी लड़की जंगल में जाती थी तो फोरस ने इसके कपड़े फाड़ लाका ने पकड़ ली थी, इसने मैं गार्ड बांधी है कि मैं एक बहन हूँ, मैं मेरा परिवार को मेरा समाज को मैं कुछ करके बताऊंगी। मैं एक आंगनवाड़ी पण चलाती हूँ, इसने मैं इत्यार सुधी में कुछ नहीं मांगा गवर्नमेंट को, सब बोले के गवर्नमेंट देगा देगा, मेरा काम देखेगा तो गवर्नमेंट खुद आवेगा, तो ये है गवर्नमेंट जे ने अपना। मेरे इसने सपने है कि मेरा छोटा मानस था बच्चू पर इंग्लिश के ये पढ़ सके, ऐसा मेरा सपना है। मेरे पास जमीन तो मिल गई लड़ लड़के, पर इसका 9 लाख रुपया मांगा है। मैं लड़ती हूँ लड़ते लड़ते कोक दाता मिल जाए, मैं ऊपर वाले माथे भरोसा है। जब मेरे खुदा हो बुराई से बसा ना मुझको लेकर जोरा ही मोहम्मद के सला ना मुझको मेरे अल्लाह गरीबों से मोहब्बत करना। थैंक यू।
Ladies and gentlemen, our next real hero in this category is Dr. Chandrasekhar Sankar Athari. Can we have you on stage, please, sir? Give him a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. His story is truly inspiring. His tragedy became his strength. The loss of his wife and 2 children in the Kanishka terror bombing made Dr. Chandrasekhar return to his roots in Andhra Pradesh, and there's been no looking back since then.
I am accepting this with humility on behalf of all our staff members, because without their involvement, their commitment, I don't think I would have achieved all the things what I wanted to do. So this trophy I am going to dedicate to all of them. 70% of the people living in India are deprived of primary education, primary health care and basic amenities. Unless we provide this, India cannot be a progressive country, in my opinion. So I request all of you to keep this in mind. Together, we can make better India. Thank you very much.
Our next real hero in this category is Sister Mariola. Can we have you on stage, please, Sister? Sister Mariola is the only connect that inmates at the Ajmer jail have with the outside world. She helps get free legal aid for women behind bars and also helps them earn a license. Sister Mariola, a true friend, philosopher and guide to many.
Sitting behind was so comfortable, so good to see a galaxy of heroes coming up and in the presence of, if I may say, the glitterati of Bombay. But when it's my
Don't
turn...
say Bombay, you'll get us into trouble. You have to say Mumbai.
Mumbai.
Don't worry. You can say Bombay and get away. Don't worry. You can happily say Bombay.
But when it's my turn to come up, there's a kind of fear, a sense of guilt, because what has a nun and honor got to do? I mean, the two don't go together. Honor of this kind, I feel, don't go together. A nun should continue doing what she's been doing nonetheless, if I may say. I'll get the honor, I'll get this check and this glory. And what happens to the prisoners? People behind bars, it will take a long time for them to really get out. The politeness of a nation can be gauged at the way we treat our offenders. I think they need a better deal.
Thank you very much, Sister Mariola. Ladies and gentlemen, our last real hero this evening, may I please call on stage Sujata Bhatt and Kalpana Mallya from Asha Jeevan. Can we have you on stage, our real heroes in the category of social welfare? Sujata and Kalpana started Asha Jeevan, a home for mentally disturbed elders. With more than 90 senior citizens under their care, both Sujata and Kalpana gave up their professions as an architect and a secretary with a private firm to turn caregivers.
We never started this organization thinking that we are going to get something out of this. We just thought it's going to be old age home. We never realized we are going to take people who are totally bedridden. Because out of 89 centers in Bangalore today, we admit people who are totally bedridden and who are also suffering from Alzheimer and dementia, which nobody admits. Making us ordinary people to look heroes in front of the whole country, I mean, the gathering over here, it is overwhelming. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for the honor that you have worked.
Before we go to the Lifetime Achievement Award to a very special person, Mukesh Bhai, first of all, thank you as always.
You know, all this started when Rajdeep and I were having a steak dinner at Rashtrapati Bhavan. And I think we all told Rajdeep that the media is not doing enough. And he challenged me on the staircase, really, to saying, why don't we do something together? And
I think you said the media only shows the negative.
The media only shows the negative and the media only celebrates the celebrities.
That's right.
And we needed to change that. So this was the first initiative. The satisfaction to me comes is that after we started, a lot many such things have happened. So the intention was really to create a movement. And today in our third year, we have a movement. It's the movement of real heroes. What we have seen today is what money cannot buy. And that is what, as I think one of the awardees said, what is India's tradition is insaniyat, what people can do for people. And that is a movement that we have created.
Well, on this note, I'd like to call on Vanna Malik on stage, please, director of Network 18, to please give a memento of our utmost appreciation and thanks.
आप चाहते हैं कि कोई आपको पहचाने नहीं
नहीं विचार को पहचाने
विचार को पहचाने व्यक्ति को नहीं